Haribo, you are coming to the top of the mountain we call Govardhan. Well, Govardhan is there. And I wanted to continue a little bit on this video that I shot just now. And I was filling you guys a little bit into the tattva of what I'm practicing, the bhakti yoga. Tattva being a word for philosophy in Sanskrit. I try to make these videos for my own purification, as a lot of these bhaktas say. You do this for your purification, and you do that for your purification. And I mean, you gotta admit it, like Gandhi said, and our teacher as well, you gotta save yourself before you can save anybody else. I mean, they say it in an airplane too. Put that gas mask on before you help anybody else. I mean, that's for kids mainly, but still, you're useless if you're not strong, if you haven't realized things. And I haven't realized shit, I'm sorry to say, but that's how it goes. And I mean, I can say that and I can still think, oh well, actually, I have realized this and that. But in the end, there's always something to learn. And the thing is, these things are mystical. These things we're practicing are mystical. And yeah, like, my tattva there in the last video had some gaping holes. So here, just so you guys understand a little bit more about this cult and this philosophy, I need to emphasize a couple points about love. Couple more points about love. Bhakti is devotion. So devotion involves loving somebody. How can you be devoted to anything or anybody? In India, the word bhakti is used interchangeably for... You have bhakti for your wife, you have bhakti for your cows, you have bhakti for whatever. You're devoted. You're married, you're devoted. So what's the supreme cause of devotion, of your bhakti? Well, you're devoted to one who can take all your love. And that's great. If you think that's your wife, that's great. I mean, on a material level, on one level, yes, a person can take it all. And believe me, I have met some gorgeous souls. And actually, at the moment too, I know some gorgeous souls. And yeah, we can give a lot. But not one single person, not one single being on this entire world, entire universe, not to mention other universes, whoa, if you believe in that, there's not a single thing that can take all of what we have to give. So that's why we devote to somebody or something, however you want to see it. But bhakti sees it as Ishvara Krishna, so the supreme controller. Supreme controller is there. There needs to be a supremacy. And that supremacy, I mean, God, this is a horrible connotation these days. And people say, religion's done this, religion's done that. Yeah, they've done a lot of bad, but hey, come on, give some credit. Religions have done some good too, and there's a noble cause to every religion. There has been, and the more mystical religion goes, the more mystical any monastic tradition goes, and all traditions of religion have monastic traditions in them. So the more mystical any tradition goes, it starts, whoops-a-doo, it starts recognizing that there's something to it. And that something to it is what every religion recognizes as God. You have different words for it. And the Naam, the word, the name, has a very, very high significance. That's why we chant Japa. We have these names for God. We have these transcendental sound vibrations that are to liberate, that are to bring forth the easing, the loving tendency in our hearts that we've all longing for. Krishna just means the reservoir of all pleasure, the one who can take it all. So as much as I said, we're here to enjoy. Yes, we're here to enjoy. But in bhakti tradition, the enjoyment isn't fully for us to enjoy the material nature. That is to perpetuate our suffering. And that's what everybody understands in any mystical tradition. The more we put emphasis on us enjoying things, the more our attachment raises. The more we're attached to these things, the more we suffer when we have to let go of these things. And hey, guess what? Everything's transitory. There was a thunderstorm there. And there's going to be another thunderstorm tonight. Just last night, we were watching in awe, thinking it's friggin' aliens. I thought it was aliens last night. And I was kind of scared. Night before, actually, yeah. And last night, boom, there it is. It's a lightning storm. Some gods fighting there. Oh, Some gods, yeah, that's funny. That's gonna get you wrapped up too. There's only one supreme controller, but he's got like little agents. So that's kind of the Hindu philosophy in the eyes of bhakti. You know, there's a supreme controller who has his little secretaries and his ships all these. He actually ships somebody to ship these secretaries too. So it's a cool little hierarchy. And hierarchy is another thing I used to be so against. It's kind of anti-hierarchy and anti a lot of things. And that was also a lot of suffering. But so, as much as I'm into this vista and I'd like to sit here for hours and just kick back with a whole freezer of ice cream things and slurpy doodlies and suck on them and look at this and watch everything go by, that's just what's going to happen to my ice cream. I'm going to run out and my chair is going to break. It's going to become a rainy season and ice cream won't taste good anymore. So that's the material nature for you. And that's what I wanted to say. We have to have somebody who can take all that we have to give. And I've chosen that somebody for me through this vast scriptural evidence to be, which is the oldest religion in the world as well. They claim, all the scriptures claim, that it's a knowledge of immemorial times. So time is even something that's relevant. It's fascinating, and I'm just starting to get into it, but I'm into it, and I hope you get into it too, but I'm not pushing nothing, because I've been pushed a lot of things, like Christianity, and I wasn't into it. So I didn't get into it. So if I'm pushing something, I'd be a bit of a hypocrite. Everybody's a hypocrite to a certain degree, but don't be a big hypocrite. That'll make you a big poo. And that's not funny for everybody, because poo stinks. So here's my my beautiful spiel and all this. I didn't even need coffee to turbo talk in foreign tongue this fast. But I'm going down, I'm thirsty. And hope you enjoyed this video. I think there's like a little thumbs up thing. So if you can put a thumbs up and you liked what you heard, yeah, like it, because I think I'm gonna get more publicity this way, and I'm actually gonna just maybe try and like start a little something so I can serve Madhuvan better. I've chosen to maybe live here at least part of the year as it stands. I'm not making any super mega decisions right now, but I'd like to start some kind of a thing that I can run off of donations from doing some kind of business online. I'm thinking some kind of a cool little, I don't know, I'll keep it as a secret, and let you know later. I'm planning a trip to India too, so there might be some kind of alchemical processes that's gonna go on and bring forth some kind of transmutation to the vast cyclical progression of this transcendental nature of our current beautiful golden age that we're living. So hey, if I can be part of that, all I really care about is to serve, and that's what I'm learning. So that's my new thing, and I'm glad if you can dig it. If you can't dig it, then I don't really honestly care, but I like all ya. So if we can stay friends, that's all right. Whatever we can share in this life path, it's great. We don't all have to be the tightest homies, but I mean, you know, and we go through phases too. And you guys might think I'm gone a little bit of Hare Krishna, and I have. But hey, at least I'm not secular. At least I went through the deep end a little bit more in the beginning, like, you know, half a year ago. And I was a little bit weird in the beginning. So forgive me, peace. All who I turned a little weird on. So maybe we can stay buds. And maybe there's going to be cool things in the future. Maybe not. Maybe we're not going to see each other anymore. But hey, I wish you all good. And talk to you later. See you again. Arigato.